ABC preempts its regularly scheduled programming for the following special, brought to you this Christmas morning by Walt Disney World.
Oh, boy!
Merry Christmas, America, Canada, Europe, and service men and women watching around the world.
It's Mickey. What's wrong?
I forgot the decoration!
Well, do something right this very minute, because...
Live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida, it's the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Hold up the honey, put up the tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stockings, we may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now. For we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window.
Stars Joan Lunden and Ben Vereen.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly.
With Regis Philbin and holiday greetings from around the world. Coming your way, all the magic and laughter of a Disney Christmas. A holiday peek at EPCOT Center's new Living Seas Pavilion. Plus, a behind-the-scenes look at Caption EO, starring Michael Jackson. Participating advertisers of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade are Eckert Drugs. When you're in Florida or anywhere in the South, you're close to an Eckert drugstore. For photo processing, prescriptions, or just about anything else you need. And Gaines Foods, makers of Gravy Train and other fine Gaines dog food. Gaines, the company that shares America's love of dogs. And now, here are your hosts, Joan Lunden and Ben Vereen.
Wow, and with a beginning like that, how could it be anything but a Merry Christmas? Merry Christmas, everybody, and Merry Christmas to a Merry Elf.
Merry Elf.
Ben Vereen.
Thank you, Joan. Merry Christmas. And Merry Christmas to everyone, and I do mean everyone. This is probably the biggest audience I've ever played to. An estimated 50 million people are watching all around the world.
And they are going to see the best parade yet. Plus, go to EPCOT Center's new Living Seas Pavilion, see Michael Jackson at work on a new 3D Disney movie, and maybe we will see you dance, maybe just a little bit.
Ave Maria!
All right, well, we are going to get started in just a moment, so don't you go away.
Welcome back to Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade. And just where is this parade? Well, it's winding its way through Frontierland. In just a few minutes, it'll be on Main Street, USA, right in front of our cameras.
You've been involved in a lot of very big productions, I know, but anything quite like this?
No, not quite. Over 300 performers, all those floats, that's a lot of rehearsing and a lot of staging. No wonder they get it right. They've been rehearsing this thing since summer, proving that practice makes perfect.
And I think that the people on Main Street are getting pretty excited. And speaking of Main Street, let's go down there right now to our co-host, Regis Philbin. Regis, how is it down
there? Thank you, Joan, and Merry Christmas to you. Yeah, we got a lot of excitement down here. We got Jeff from Michigan right here. How are you, Jeff? A lot of folks from Canada. You know, the one thing about the crowds here, you never know where they're from. They're really from all over the world. Nice to have you with us, Jeff. Now, here's Gary from Polk City,
Iowa.
Who comes every other year, right?
Right, every other year.
Nice to have you here. And some lady here who has just moved from Long Island to Florida?
Kissimmee, Florida.
Kissimmee, Florida? Is that the way you pronounce it?
Kissimmee.
What about at night?
Kissimmee.
Uh-huh. See how you are? Very good. Anyway, it's nice to... And where are you from, young man?
I said... My parents said Maryland.
Yeah, but you're really from Tennessee, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
No, the kid's all confused. Anyway, we got a lot of folks here. This lady is wearing earmuffs. Can you believe it? Never wear earmuffs here at Disney. And here, if you come here, you got to have cameras. Cameras! zebras right here. All right. All right, that's what's going on down here on Main Street. We're all waiting for the parade. Now back to you and Ben, Joan.
Thank you, Regis. You're having a ball down there. You know, I think Regis maybe has the best seat in the house. He's earned it, though, because he's gone above and beyond the call of duty. And a little bit later, he's going to take us over to the Living Seas at EPCOT Center. When Regis gets to the bottom of a story, he gets to the bottom of a story. And he went clear to the ocean bottom for this one. You'll see what I mean in just a bit.
But right now, there's something goofy going on at Cinderella's castle. Let's take a look.
Of all the things of all the year that I'm familiar with, there's only one that's really fun. No, that's not it.
Mother's Day?
Father's Day?
Children's Day, too!
It's true, they're all special, but please continue.
Flag Day!
4th of July!
No, you're not trying.
We've got it now!
You do?
St. Patrick's Day!
Nope, keep going.
Easter!
Thanksgiving!
The first day of duck hunting season.
Pow! Pow! Pow!
Oh, hello, Mrs. Scrooge.
I know the answer. Payday!
Payday?
No, that's not it. Now think of December and wintry snow and look at the calendar and watch the days go.
December 19th, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th.
Hold it, you're close.
December the 25th.
Correct.
December the 25th, New Year's, December the 25th.
Correct, the rainiest day in all the year.
December the 25th.
A day in history that's more than any myth. Beyond a doubt, one day stands out.
December the 25th.
Correct. I don't hear any argument, so may I say forthwith, I wish that every day could be
December the 26th.
December the 25th.
December the 26th.
The dearest day in all the year.
December the 26th.
You don't seem to understand.
December the 25th.
I'm gonna tell you one more time.
December the 26th.
One last time.
Make no mistake about it, it is December the 25th, Christmas Day, and our parade is just about ready to start.
What would a parade be without a band from West Orange High School right outside of Walt Disney World in Florida? We have the West Orange High Marching Warriors.
Great. Just in case you didn't get the message from that, Mickey Mouse is coming to town. In fact, he'll be in our parade, which is now at the starting position.
And we'll blow the whistle and march them out right after this.
Oh, welcome back to the parade. You got here just in time because you know what, Ben?
What?
It is time to start the show. So let's go down to Main Street, USA for the start of Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Thank you. love a fanfare, and that's what we have right here. The Fanfare Trumpeters, led down the street by Major Mike. And that means our parade is officially underway.
That's right, and these are royal musicians, Ben, called into service by none other than the queen of this magic kingdom herself, Cinderella. And that, of course, is her castle right smack in the center of things down there. You know, out in Disneyland in California, Sleeping Beauty reigns in her own castle. She has her own band, too. I kind of wondered, what would it be like if we got those two together?
Oh, gee, I think it'd be really something. Quite a jam session, you might say.
Oh, what a shot of Main Street,
USA
there.
Isn't that
beautiful? All fixed up for Christmas.
You know, they really worked around the clock to get this together for tonight. You know, there must be royalty on the way because look what's behind the band. It's the night of the Magic Kingdom.
I think this is one of my favorites every year. It kind of brings back a time of chivalry and honor. The armors are so beautiful. In a moment, you'll see the silks on the dancers. It's a beautiful part of the parade. And those percheron horses are so huge. The children are just in awe when they look up at them.
Sure. You know, Joan, I know a little something about this era from the time I played in Pippin on Broadway. That's the beautiful thing about the theater. You see, you get to learn a lot about everything. You really do.
Do you have to put on armor like that?
No, you see, the thing about putting on that armor, I found out from doing Pippin, is that when you put on that armor in the morning, if you fell over, that's where you'd be all day.
Until someone came along and picked you up.
But those banners that they're carrying there, you see, those banners are actually the signs of their houses.
Kind of like license plates?
That's kind of like a license plate.
Oh, and there are the royal dancers. Oh, who is that up there?
Is that Prince Charles?
Prince Charles? That's Prince Charming
from the movie
Cinderella. He's, of course, looking for his queen. I remember a few years back, you did a wonderful song in a TV special about Walt Disney with all the characters around you, didn't you?
No, I did, Joan. And these stories and characters that Walt Disney and his artists created, you know, I think they'll live forever.
There's the mice!
Yeah, these are the mice that helped Cinderella sew her outfit fit for the royal ball. There's Susie, Perla, and of course, Gus Gus and Jacques.
That's right. This is the longest and the tallest float in the entire parade. It's 17 feet tall. It took over 5.5 months to build. Look at the faces on the children. They love to see this go by.
Such royalty.
The castle brings its own celebration with it. There are the royal dancers twirling their way to the ball, wearing, of course, their finest satins and brocades and precious jewels sewn all over them.
Well, Joan, that's how you dress when you're escorting this lady.
Oh, for which lady? This lady? Cinderella in her coach.
Yes, isn't she beautiful?
She's pulled by 6 tiny ponies, which of course were actually mice, right?
Yes, I know those mice.
And the coach is actually a pumpkin, turned into a coach, of course, by the fairy godmother. And if you look closely, can you see the little vines? The vines make up the coach's frame.
Hey, let's check in with Regis down on Main Street. Regis probably has a better look at this coach. Regis, how's everybody taking to all this royalty?
Okay, a lot of fun down here. We have a family from Minnesota, believe it or not. All the way from Laverne, Minnesota. This is the Larry Bowl family. Turn around, they're all just alike. And here it is, the Vern Drive-In Theater. Can you believe that? But there's a lot of Disney clothes to be seen these days. Big merchandising campaign here. Look, here's Mickey Mouse. Everybody's wearing this. Here's Minnie Mouse right over here. Here's Minnie and Mickey. And I love these kids in their hats right here. Everybody wearing Mickey Mouse stuff. Lady, how are you? Nice to see you. And finally, of course, if you want a hat, why, there's no better hat than the old Pluto hat. Right.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
All right, that's it from the street. Back up to you, Ben and Joan.
Thank you, Regis.
Oh, look who's down there, Ben.
Yes, yes. It's Mr. Ringmaster. He's the leader of all this mayhem that you see going on Main Street there.
When Mom and Dad, things get a little hectic at your house this season, just think of this guy trying to keep his act together. It's a futile effort. Look at those guys right there. Look at all the clowns.
Look like they're clowning it up a bit, doesn't it?
Oh, they really bring smiles to all the children's faces.
You know, it sort of looks like a rehearsal I've been to. A few rehearsals I've been to, actually.
They've got some of the... Oh, and there is the train. Casey Jr.
chocolate.
He's a merry fellow there.
I believe that's King Louis. All right, here's
Oh, but hey, let's talk about trouble, though. Here's someone with a hot problem on his hands. It's Dumbo, and he's trapped in a burning firehouse.
Dumbo has always been one of my favorites. You know, this movie was released in 1941. And when I was a little girl, I used to go to Disneyland. I remember Disneyland opened, I think, in 1955, and I was there shortly after. It was my most favorite attraction. Look at him there with his big ears. Think he's gonna be okay?
Oh, come on, Joan. You know how the story goes. You saw the movie. He's gonna spread those beautiful ears and just fly on down to safety. Look at those firemen there. They're there to save him, to help Dumbo.
Somehow I get the feeling that they aren't gonna do it for him.
This particular guy happens to be a pachyderm pilot without peer.
What did you say?
A pachyderm pilot without peer.
Huh. Very good.
Yeah, I know. Thanks. Wait till I lay on you supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Oh, now I'm impressed. Now I'm impressed. Those firemen down there do not look like they're taking it, taking care of things. Oh, look at this. This is it Calliope or Calliope, since you're so wonderful with words today?
Well, Joan, everybody knows if you're a real circus person, it's Calliope. But I like the Calliope myself.
Do you remember the Disney movie, Toby Tyler?
I sure do.
This Calliope, if you will, was used in that movie, along, of course, with a lot of other movies.
There's something else about this Calliope, or Calliope, as you like to say. This past year, was the 30th birthday of Disneyland in California. Well, this Calliope took part in the opening day parade in Disneyland way back in 1955. So its appearance here today is kind of a tribute from Walt Disney World to Disneyland. Happy birthday, guys.
Oh, happy birthday. Really, it even has a longer history. It was built in London, England in 1907. It first appeared in the Megabon and Bower show, and I think it was about in the 20s that it went to the Ho's Great London Show, and then it kind of made its way over to the U.S. in the 40s, where Walt Disney saw it and bought it. It's a beauty. Ah, here we have Jungle Book. Look at this, Ben. There's Mowgli out there dancing away.
No, Mowgli, yes, he was a jungle boy. He was raised by the wolves in the jungle. And isn't that King Hati, the orangutan out there? Oh, no, Colonel Hati is the elephant. Right?
That's right.
And the orangutan is King Louie.
That's right. These are
the
fearsome, awesome, majestic inhabitants of the Jungle Book.
Wait a minute. Are we looking at the same thing here, Joan?
Well, that might be a little literary license. I think they're a bit more foolish than fearsome. Here's their backup.
Ah, but dig that rhythm.
There's rhythm in there somewhere?
Yeah, can't you hear that?
Oh, there we go. There we go. Yeah.
That's the Jungle Book Band playing Colonel Hathi's March, one of the songs from the Jungle Book. And one of the other great songs was Bare Necessities. Remember that?
Oh, I love that song. And for all the kids out there watching, you should know that Jungle Book is really a book by Rudyard Kipling called Mowgli's Stories. You can find it at the library along with a lot of other really good books that Walt Disney read himself and then decided to make movies out of. So you can read them too.
And do. Take the time, kiddo. Lots of fun. Well, it's time to take a break from this jungle. And in fact, I think it's time to take a break from the whole parade. But we'll be right back. So
don't go away.
Merry Christmas to Wickliffe, New Jersey.
Merry Christmas to everyone in Iowa, especially my grandparents in Cedar Falls.
There's more magic on the way, so stay right where you are.
Very Merry Christmas Parade. The parade's rolling along on Main Street, and we'll get back to it in just a moment. But first, we're going to go all the way across the country to Disneyland in California for a story about a birthday party they threw this year to kick off their holiday season. And here's a good friend of mine to tell you all about it. Here's
Welcome
Kevin
to the land
Dobson.
Where the magic began, Disneyland. I'm standing in front of Sleeping Beauty Castle where so many Disney holiday celebrations have begun. This year was a little different. Just a few days ago, Disneyland's hometown of Anaheim threw one heck of a 30th birthday party for Disneyland.
It's a time we're going to honor a man who
followed his dreams who created something that I think has changed the world.
On what would have been Walt Disney's 84th birthday, this proud city set a Guinness World Record by releasing over 1 million balloons into the California sky to honor the man and the land that taught us all how to believe in magic.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Isn't that a once-in-a-lifetime sight? It's a beautiful rainbow of color that will travel hundreds of miles. Walt Disney would have loved Skyfest. What a wonderful present, 1 million balloons. I can't think of a better way to celebrate this season of joy. From all of us here at Disneyland in California, a most magical Christmas to all of you throughout the world. Merry Christmas! Mwah! 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 Mwah!
Thank you, Kevin.
Now, that is the way to kick off the holidays, with a birthday party like that at a place that really started it all.
Isn't it amazing that from Disneyland came Walt Disney World and then Tokyo Disneyland?
That's right. And the other day it was announced, too, that there's going to be a new Euro Disneyland in France, right outside of Paris.
You know, that should be a natural, because the European people love the characters that were created here by the Disney people. But let's get down to Main Street right now and Herbie the Bug, one of Europe's favorites.
Oh, Herbie the Bug, I love it. He's been a hit all over Europe, and there he is doing his routine. It's not so easy to give this guy a ticket. Watch this.
Oh, the kids love this. You know, it's crazy. Cops are going to need a few lessons from traffic control in France, those gendarmes there. They'll teach them how to handle Herbie, I guess.
Up, oh, here comes that sassy little bug. Whoa!
No!
A great, great movie, too. It was a surprise success, Ben, for the studios. It was released in 1969. The movie starred Dean Jones and Michelle Lee and Buddy Hackett. And it is a favorite out here on Main Street.
It sure is a favorite today.
Now, what's this? These are the characters of Robin Hood, right from Sherwood Forest. And you know the good Prince Charming that we saw a little earlier, Ben?
Yes.
Well, not every prince is a prince, if you know what I mean. And we're going to see right there in that carriage in a moment a prince that is a rat. There he is, peeking out of there.
Oh, I can see him, that sneaky
well,
cat.
He's not really a rat. He's a lion, right?
Yeah, you're right.
Well, I mean, honestly, he's a lion.
He's a tiger. He's a sneaky cat.
Oh, and those are his hippo henchmen there.
You know, but even these tough guys can't keep our hero down.
No.
Sneer, boo.
Boo, hiss. While his good brother King Richard was away fighting in the crusade, Prince John has been terrorizing the people. And there thou our good guy, Robin Hood.
Our hero.
He robs from the rich and gives to the poor, and with him, of course, is Maid Marian and not so little John and Friar Tuck.
Yes.
Very first book ever printed about Robin Hood was printed in 1520. So this story has been around for a long time. And when it was told in stories with very easy lyrics. So that's why it's so easy to remember. Those are your favorites.
Yes, they're the funky monks. Doing the funky monk step.
Nice move.
I like those moves.
Okay, you see who's coming up there right behind the band? Somebody yelled, "Bring on the wenches!" And here they are. That's Prince John's doing, no doubt.
Of course.
But somewhere in there, I think, should be Friar Tuck,
too. Yeah, he's there doing his job.
Yeah, trying to keep them all in line. Friar's worth a check with that.
He never is.
Even in Sherwood Forest, they celebrate Christmas.
Let's listen to the band play for a while, because they're really cooking down there. Sassy winches they are, aren't they? Oh, the kids having a ball tonight. can't handle all this. Now, Christmas is celebrated in some pretty unusual places, John. And we're going to go to one of those places right now. Would you believe to the bottom of the sea?
Bottom of the sea?
That's right. Regis had a chance to dive into the story, and he took it.
You bet I did, Ben. I jumped on the Christmas monorail to EPCOT Center and headed straight for the Living Seas Pavilion. Would you believe there's an ocean in that building? A 5.5 million gallon underwater world that's due to open in January. I mean a real live ocean in that building. This I've got to see. Ah, a human. That's a good start. This is Kim Murphy, one of the Disney guys who put this place together. So, Kim, you and I together through this whole project, right?
That's right, Regis. In fact, I'll be there when you hit bottom.
Oof.
Don't want to hear that. Well, are you ready to go?
Ready to go? Where are my fins?
The fins are on the fish. Oh. Here we don't need fins. We take a hydrolator to the bottom. Come on.
I know that. Okay, this is it. The doors are closing.
Are you ready?
I hope so. Right, that's some feeling. We're in the hydrolator, huh?
Right. Hydrolators are deep submergence vehicles taking us to the sea base.
And the sea base being?
Well, our sea base is a state-of-the-art subsea ocean research facility.
Oh, it's slowing up now.
Right, we're almost there.
Coming to an end.
Hydrolator number one.
Right. Wow, that was some kind of ride.
Fantastic.
Now, what's this?
These are the sea cabs, and they'll take us from this arrival port into the sea base concourse.
And take me to my shark. Well, now this is it. Now we're a part of the ocean.
You really are a part of the ocean.
Oh, gee, look at this. Absolutely incredible. How many fish do we have here?
Right now, the population stands at about 4,000. Tremendous variety.
Gee, look at all that.
Isn't that beautiful? I mean, I see it every day, and I love it.
Yeah, so graceful looking.
We'll have research programs ongoing continuously and publishable work by our own scientists.
Including some stuff with dolphins actually involved with computers.
They will. In our case, rather than doing shows, the dolphins become members of the research team, and they'll actually interact with the computer systems.
Fantastic. Kim went to see some old pals, but he told me to be sure and check out this deep rover. It's being tested to take scientists down some 20,000 feet where they breathe the same way we do on land. Just think of it now for a minute. You get to explore the ocean depths, and when you come up, you don't have to decompress. It's as simple as that, and truly amazing. But now I've got to catch up with Kim. Say, can you tell me where Kim and his friends are?
Sure, follow me.
Terrific. So these are your friends. I've never been to the Dolphins' dressing room before. What goes on here?
Well, aside from losing my 15th game of water polo with these guys, as I mentioned in our communication research program with the Dolphin, they are members of the team, and we spend a lot of time in their environment and working directly with them.
Are they as smart as we think they are?
Frankly, after the years that I've been around them, I think they're possibly a little smarter.
Well, as you can see, things have certainly come a long way in undersea exploration. Remember our old friend Bruce? Well, now here's Kim in the latest diving gear, and we can even communicate with him via this new technology. Kim, you look real great, but can you hear me okay?
I can hear you just perfectly, Regis.
And that new face mask makes it all happen, huh?
Well, you can see it does give me an unobstructed field of vision and has a nasal and mouth area that allows me to speak quite clearly.
Very clearly. And I see you're feeding our friends in there.
Well, I'm getting a manicure, actually, but they're very hungry.
There's a lot of activity behind you. What's going on?
Well, you'll notice a robotic submersible that we have that has an onboard video camera very similar to your television cameras.
Mm-hmm.
We also have some vehicular systems that pull our divers through the water at fairly high speed.
And that robot is handled by somebody topside, right?
Yes, it is. It's a very practical tool for us.
Terrific. Listen, I know you've got to go. I've got to go, too, and I thank you very much, Kim.
Okay.
Well, listen, Joan and Ben, I mean, I just can't get over how much we still have to learn about the oceans of the world. But this Living Seas really seems like a good place to start. And when we really do conquer Earth's last frontier, who knows what strange and mysterious creatures we'll find waiting for us, or what they'll have to say.
That's lovely.
Oh, I think I recognize that guy back there.
I think we all recognize that guy back there.
Regis didn't go in the tank, though.
Oh, but I went in the tank.
I heard. I'm so
and
jealous.
And it was wonderful. They really have created an ocean environment. And for people who are into oceanography or into diving, into snorkeling, into swimming, period, you will enjoy the Living Seas. I mean, I was there swimming with the dolphins. I was swimming with the angel fish, the monterey. And I was feeding the fish. That was Kim yesterday, feeding the fish. It was like, I was lost. It felt like I was doing my act. All of a sudden, I wanted to do my act for the fish. Right there.
That's great. And of course, anyone will be able to come and visit the Living Seas Pavilion starting January the 15th.
That's right.
And you'll all get to see more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade right after we come back from these messages. Don't go away.
Don't go away.
Welcome back to Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade, everybody. We're live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida, and here are some characters that are plenty live.
You better believe it.
Yes, here's Nibblelips McGraw. Here's Shaker and Wendell from the Country Bear Jamboree, and they're kicking up some dust.
Have you seen the Country Bear Jamboree show?
I sure have.
It is great. And these bears don't travel alone. You can see that they brought some singing and dancing with them. The group up there on the hay wagon is hand-picked, and let's listen.
Hay rides and smiling and laughing and lots of good.
You know, these guys are great musicians, right? Here in Disneyland is some of the best I think I've heard. And that's the wonderful thing about being here at Disney World. You know, you hear a group or a band at every corner.
Look at that shot. All right, speaking of music, Ben, here comes a movie that gave the world what you might call the Disney theme song, When You Wish Upon a Star. It's Pinocchio and the whole gang.
Yes, and there's Pinocchio with his dad, Geppetto, the puppet maker. Remember how he wished and wished for a little boy, and his wish finally came true?
That's right. And his wish came true because of this magical lady right here, the Blue Fairy. She lives on the Wishing Star, so when you make a wish, that's who you're wishing to.
Oh, what a lovely lady to wish to.
The movie Pinocchio was released in 1940. Oh, there's some bad guys coming out there.
They sure are. That's Honest John, the fox, and his henchman, Gideon. And they've got Pinocchio taking him down the road to ruin. Remember the lesson that Pinocchio learned? A lie grows and grows until it's as plain as the nose on your face.
That's right, and a good lesson.
There's Stromboli.
Oh, he's one of the great characters, the mean puppeteer. He threw Pinocchio in a cage, and he wasn't going to let him out either. But, of course, the Blue Fairy came along and got him out of that jam.
That's right. And look at all the puppets Stromboli still has locked up. The puppet clowns. And the can-can dancers. Oh, my goodness. Do you know what all these puppets need? They need what Pinocchio had. A conscience to be their guide. Look at them dancing along, all being held by the strings of Stromboli.
This is one of the all-time great Disney animated features.
You know, When You Wish Upon a Star won an Oscar for Disney.
Right.
That's right. Hi Diddly Dee, An Actor's Life for Me. One of the great songs. I think that was one of my favorites. That's how I became an actor, I think.
All right, what was the name of the whale that swallowed Geppetto?
Ooh,
Monstro.
Monstro.
Is that what I hear everybody yelling there at home? Monstro is the name of the whale.
This is probably one of Disney's movies that the strange story is this was actually scratched. They scratched this one and then they started from scratch again.
Really?
Yes.
Hey, speaking of conscience,
my favorite guys,
Jiminy Cricket. And he is very proud of the official conscience medal that the Blue Fairy gave him for helping Pinocchio.
That's right.
Such great Disney memories. You had a chance, didn't you? To even be out there in Los Angeles at the Disney Studios where all these beautiful Disney memories were made. And look at them coming down the street right now with all the garland up at the top. They've been putting this up for months and months.
Why? You know, Joan,
I did have a chance to go out to Walt Disney Studios in California, and what a great, great place. And while I was there, I had a chance to learn a little something about how these magic movies are made, and get a special preview of a 3D film starring Michael Jackson. And I happened to take a few pictures.
Really?
Yeah, I did. Would you like to see them?
I would.
I'd love for you to see them. Would you roll the tape, please?
Ask people where Hollywood's most famous intersection is, and they'd probably tell you Hollywood and Vine, but they've never seen the corner of Mickey Avenue and Dopey Drive. This is Walt Disney Studios in Burbank, California. And if you've ever wondered where dreams are made, this is the place. This is the place where Fantasia and Peter Pan took flight, where the Mickey Mouse Club held its first meeting, where Mary Poppins dropped in to work a little magic, and where Walt Disney laid the plans for Disneyland, Walt Disney World, and even EPCOT Center. And hey, you never forget where you are. Over there is the animation building. Here's the back lot, where all those great shows like Zorro and Pollyanna were filmed. And this is one of the sound stages that to the eye looks like a big empty box. But when a little film magic's put into this box, it becomes anything from a Jules Verne submarine to a 3D spaceship. In fact, it was in a sound stage just like this a few weeks ago that a 3D spaceship was built for one of the newest Disney dreams. It's a 3D musical space fantasy starring Michael Jackson, produced by George Lucas and directed by Francis Ford Coppola. It's called Caption EO, and the only way you'll be able to see this movie is in the special 3D theaters in EPCOT Center in Florida and Disneyland in California. Now, Caption EO won't be out until March, but hey, this is a magical place, right? Right. So, before we go back to Florida and the parade, let's do a little magic ourselves and get a behind-the-scenes peek at Caption EO. Oh, it's okay. I know Mickey.
Michael follows. He steps cautiously. Fuzzball looks around, comes back, goes to Michael, tells Michael to go on. Keep moving. They push Hooter out. He's chicken.
Be quiet.
Come on.
Shot. Good.
Around his face. He don't know what to do.
You see the people moving.
Okay, and say Hooter right away.
Oh.
Why don't you throw the tape? Hooter. Hooter.
Okay.
A strong character with a charm and smile that then turns into this real powerhouse.
Yeah, let's shoot it. Can't take the suspense.
Wow, Michael Jackson, George Lucas, and Francis Ford Coppola. Not a bad team, right?
Not a bad team.
You dare you to try to sit still during that one.
Caption EO is going to be quite a project. The music that Michael Jackson has written for this film is incredible. I mean, it's going to have you rocking and rolling and just having yourselves a good time. EO in Greek means dawn, and I think that Caption EO is the dawn of a whole new adventure into cinematography for the Disney World people.
You bet.
And as I said, it can only be seen here at Disney World and in Disneyland.
In
so,
special 3D theaters.
Special 3D
That's
theaters.
That's right. All right, we're going to be back, so you stay with us. When we come back, we will have none other than Cruella DeVille and the 101 Dalmatians.
Ooh.
Let's
going on out there?
Oh, Merry Christmas, Stowe, Vermont. Merry Christmas, Charlotte, North Carolina.
Merry Christmas, Bronx.
Merry Christmas, Elkhart, Indiana.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. We'll be right back.
Oh, welcome back to Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade. You changed clothes.
Oh, yes, I did. I had to put on my Mickey team jacket.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, for all my
kids. Great.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh,
it's for all my kids who drew these fabulous pictures for me. These, you see, these particular pictures are from cards that kids made at the Nova Blanche Foreman School in Hollywood, California.
And they Hollywood, Florida.
Oh, Florida, I'm sorry.
They have one here, too.
Yeah, Florida. See, I keep getting confused going back and forth. Kevin. So they drew these pictures for us, and this is a service that we have here at Disney World. When you bring your kids down, they have the opportunity of learning from the animators at this particular place. And this particular picture is from Monique Goldberg. And Monique, we'd like to thank you and thank all the kids here at Disney who are participating in the program.
And they're probably watching this morning and ready for some more parade. But right now, let's go back down to Main Street and to Regis. How's it going down there, Reg?
Well, we're doing pretty good down here. There's a little break in the action, as you know. Everybody having a good time?
Yeah!
Yes. They really are, too. It's a wonderful parade. And when you're this close to all the characters, I mean, all the flood of memories come back from when you were a kid, too. How you doing this morning? Incidentally, my children are here, too. This is Joanna and Jennifer. Hi, gang. How you doing?
Hi.
Have you had a nice Christmas so far?
Oh, yeah.
Very good.
What has been your favorite part of the parade up to now, Joanna?
I think the Cinderella float.
You always thought you were Cinderella, didn't you? I mean, you always wanted to be Cinderella. And Jay?
I like the Pinocchio spot. I thought that was real cute.
He is cute, isn't he? Now, listen, we've been here for a couple of days having a good time. And what's been the favorite ride so far?
I guess Big Thunder Mountain Railroad.
Big Thunder Mountain is really exciting, isn't it? New Space Mountain, right?
Well, it's a little rough, but yeah, I like it.
They have done some work on Space Mountain, and they've got an extra few little razzle-dazzle turns in there, guaranteed to make the hair stand up. Okay, gang, enjoying the parade?
Yeah.
Yeah, we are. We're all having a good time down here. And now back to you, Ben and Joe.
And things are going to the dogs down there on Main Street, USA. Here's a lady ahead of her time. She's Cruella de Vil. She patented, I think, the new wave look when she started 101 Dalmatians back in 1961. Look at that lady.
Oh, look at that hairdo. You know, some of the Disney animators are still seeing spots over that one. Imagine drawing all those spots on 101 dogs.
Oh, she's getting out. She's getting out. Woo, here she goes.
Oh, listen to the beat.
Here it is,
oh,
Mary
there's
Poppins.
There's a shift in the wind. There's a magical feeling in the air, and that means who else but Mary Poppins is here.
Yep, we're going to see Mary and Bert. They pop right into a painting on the sidewalk and are out for a jolly holiday. Remember that song?
Remember all the songs.
Oh,
Shim
yeah.
Shim Cherie won an Oscar, and there was Spoonful of Sugar,
oh.
Step in Time, Feed the Birds, and of course, Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Hey, that's twice in one day for you.
I'm on a roll.
Dog. Oh, look at the little boy watching up on the top of Dad's shoulders, I think. Let's watch him dance.
This is an unforgettable movie. It starred Julie Andrews and Dick Van Dyke.
That's right.
You know, I'd like to talk a little bit about this music here because of two people who have written so much great music, like Richard and Robert Sherman. They wrote all the music for Mary Poppins. They also wrote all the music for the Jungle Book songs. And the one you just can't stop humming after you've been on the ride.
I know what that is.
It's a small world after all. Everybody, even at home, sing along. It's a small world after all.
We have to sing it all day, so do you at home.
It's a wonderful song. I love that song. And they've also written some of the great new songs for the EPCOT Center.
There are the penguins. Now the penguins are followed by the Pearly Band. And let's hear the music.
Quite a
quite a history behind it. It's from vaudeville. Charlie Chaplin got his start with the Burley Band back when. That's right.
Obviously, people can see where they got their names from. The pearls sewn all over their clothes. If they pop a pearl, they just get another one. Oh, look who's here. The marching cards.
Oh, yes. You know, we've taken a poll around here, and this next group is from the from our best movie, one of our favorite movies around here with the crew, Alice in Wonderland.
I think everyone's got a favorite, but I want you to watch these cards. They do a great routine.
Let's listen to the band. Although I think the only heart this woman has is probably on her bloomers. Off with ye heads, off with ye heads.
You know, Alice in Wonderland was based on Lewis Carroll's wonderful story. The movie was released in 1951.
Lady needs him. She needs a little real love. That's what she needs, real love.
There are the flowers. The singing flowers from the movie. Remember the song? You can learn a lot of things from the flowers. And there's the white rabbit. Say hello to the man who is always late for a very important
date. Very important.
Date.
You know, he needs to wear three watches like myself.
Yes,
that way
right.
He'll never be late, you see.
Oh, look at the white rabbit shaking hands with all the children along Main Street, USA.
Well, you know,
talk
he always
about a
charmer.
Treat. Oh.
What a charmer. Kids have anymore.
Look who's here.
Oh, there's a young lady who's on top of the world. That's Alice. She's got the best seat in the house, you know, Joan, way up there on that giant mushroom.
Yeah. Well, everything grows big down here in Florida, you know.
Sure does.
I must say, my two little girls, Lindsay and Jamie, that's their favorite. And oh, look, here are the butterflies. They grow big down here in Florida, too. Look at them. Gorgeous.
Oh, I got a correction here, Joan.
What's
those
that?
Aren't butterflies. These are bread and butterflies.
The old Alice in Wonderland nonsense, huh? Oh, look who's coming along. Twiddledee and Twiddledum. They're great fun.
Some of the great characters from this movie were the Cheshire Cat, the Mad Hatter, the March Hare.
And there it is, Main Street USA, which is part of the Magic Kingdom here. You know, it's 107 acres, but the entire Walt Disney World complex is 27,000 acres. That's about 43 square miles, or twice the size of Manhattan Island. And it, of course, contains the Magic Kingdom and EPCOT Center, and Walt Disney World Village, and all kinds of big, huge zoological park and a golf course and all the hotels and things.
It's a place to be and a place to come to if you really want to go to another world.
Oh, look who's behind that butterfly. It's Twiddledee and Twiddledum again.
Doing their routine.
We love you, Twiddledee. Beautiful shot. While the parade is working its way through the Magic Kingdom, and right now Santa should be, I think, somewhere around Frontierland, and that's where we're going to go right now, but not to see Santa. We are going to see someone else who brings smiles to people all over the world, the gentleman who has been sitting right here alongside me all morning. Let's head over to Liberty Square, where the Richard Irvine Riverboat is just docking and bringing a very special guest our way. Let's watch and listen.
Cindy, one by one, one for the little bitty baby that's born in Bethlehem. I'm gonna send thee two by two, two's for the holy parents, one's for the little bitty baby that's born in Bethlehem. I'm gonna send thee three by three, three's for the traveling wise men, two for the holy parents, one's for the little bitty baby that's born in Bethlehem. I said, go, where I send thee? How shall I send thee? I said, go, go.
In time because something big is happening on Main Street. Maybe Regis can clue us in. Regis?
Hey, Sickle, before I get there. Okay, we're on now. We're back here. Just yelling at the crowd. This guy thinks he's here to do a Capitone commercial. Not today. And there's Mr. Mack Truck. Where are you from?
Saras, Ohio.
Oh, okay, an Ohio man. All right, nice to see everybody. Anybody want to say hello to their mother? Again, we're not doing that. This child's coat is back on. This woman has taken her coat off three times now. She's got a Mickey Mouse jacket on and hopes she'll get on TV. Anyway, it's nice to see everybody here. Having a good time?
Very good time. Good.
Yeah, here we are. Wait a minute. This guy came all the way from Paris, France, right?
Oh, Rhode Island.
I'm sorry about that. Anyway, it's nice to see all of you. Nice to have you here, too. All right, that's it from the street. Now we're back. Hey, I see the wooden soldiers coming. Here they come.
All right, the Christmas finale to the parade is right on time, and look who's leading the way. The wooden soldiers from Babes in Toyland. And that's probably where all the kids watching would like to be, Toyland.
And I love these guys. A score and a half of wooden soldiers with backbones as straight as, you know, they could be dancers.
All right, let's just watch them for a moment because they are terrific. And here they come. Down Main Street, USA, at the Toy Soldiers. From Babes in Toyland, you know, Disney made over 100 feature films, 19 animated features, over 400 shorts and cartoons. He won 51 Oscars. That's more than any other single individual in history.
You know, Joan, this particular parade features over 345 costumed entertainers. If you average 6 yards of material per performer, you'd have
2,000?
That's right, 2,770 yards of material. That's a lot of material.
Oh, it's a lot of sewing all year round. This is actually a 1.2-mile parade route today. Starts in Frontierland, they come on through the Magic Castle and right down Main Street. And here is the guy that everybody loves.
Everybody loves Mickey Mouse. And look, there's Minnie Mouse at his side. Hi, Mickey. Hi, Minnie.
Hi, Mickey. Hi, Minnie. You know, we talked about how people all over the world are seeing this telecast, and 50 million people today. This is a mouse that truly is known by almost everyone all the way around the world. And some Disney people were telling me a story recently about Mickey Mouse. They had a film crew out in a very remote part of China. They encountered some mountain people who didn't speak English, and it was getting to be a kind of a tense situation. Well, all of a sudden, the mountain people saw a little picture of Mickey on their camera, and all of a sudden, everything was okay. That little picture of that little mouse transcended all languages.
I believe that, Joan, because when I was in China just this year, I was walking around, as I do, of course, performing my three watch acts, and the people of China gathered around, and they were amazed. I had one Mickey Mouse watch at that time, and they were amazed, not at the other watches, or that I was wearing three watches, but at Mickey Mouse.
That's what they wanted to see.
What smiles to their faces.
Do you know what Mickey's first movie was?
Steamboat Willie.
Well, now, Steamboat Willie was when he became a star.
That's
before
right.
He made Steamboat Willie, he made a black and white short named Plain Crazy.
That's right.
That was a long time ago, and he has been a star through all these years, and the magic lives on. When he walks out in the middle of this magic kingdom, the children's faces are, you just can't compare it to anything.
Oh, the toys are getting bigger and bigger these days. You know that, Joan? Look at this.
I think so.
This is a toy factory coming down the street, and around it are all kinds of old friends.
That's right. Pluto and Goofy are out there, or the Goof, as he is affectionately known here at Disney. All right, now, these are some favorites of my little girls, and these are brand new Disney characters. They're the Gummy Bears. I'll try their names, okay?
All right.
Tummy, Zummy, Sunny, Cubby, Gruffy, and Grammy. I think I got them all there.
My kids love these Gummy Bears, too.
And out around the toy factory, there are all kinds of teddy bears and ballerinas. And this is one of the most kinetic floats right here in the whole parade. It took 5.5 months to build that float out in Burbank, California. Look at all the things moving around.
There's
there.
a of bears on it.
Seven dwarfs. All right, can you name them?
All right. Doc, Grumpy, Sneezy, Bashful, Sleepy, Happy, and Dopey.
Oh, you did it. Very good. And, of course, there she is, Snow White.
Yes, Snow White, who slept for a year until the prince came and woke her.
You know,
with
the
gentle kiss.
Oh, it's such a beautiful story. Walt Disney won an Academy Award for Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. In fact, he actually got one big Academy Award and seven little ones, one for each of the dwarfs. And you know who presented them?
Shirley Temple.
Shirley Temple, that's right. Oh, Raggedy Ann and Andy. These are all his favorites. The very first Ann and Andy dolls that were made had big candy hearts inside, but they tended to melt. So the manufacturer switched to some cardboard hearts, if you will. Oh, look who's here.
Oh, it's Donald Duck. You know, Donald better keep an eye on that house there. That house is made of candy and gingerbread. He could be eaten out of a house at home if he's not careful.
That's right. You know Donald's little nephew's names?
Oh.
Huey.
Huey.
Dewey.
And Louie.
Oh, there are the gingerbread men.
And women.
Yes, yes, yes. I am told that Queen Elizabeth I had a surprise party for all of her court, and she gave each of the lords and ladies a giant gingerbread figure that looked just like them. I guess that's the start of these little gingerbread men and women.
Oh, and who's this? Is this...
There's Chip and Dale. All right, now, can you tell the difference between Chip and Dale?
I think one has a tooth.
Yeah, well, Chip has one tooth and a darker nose.
Darker nose, and
Dale has the two teeth and the lighter nose.
Lighter nose, of course.
Oh,
there's a candy cane.
Look who's coming now. The snowmen and the Christmas trees. The snowmen have to be careful here in Florida. They could melt
right away.
Who's leading them? Frosty?
The snowman, of course. It was corn, claw, pipe, and his button nose. And we've got the snow women.
That's right.
Or the snow ladies.
There's Captain Hook back there. Captain Hook was... Oh, there's Frosty. Oh, he almost melted. What are we going to do? And the three little pigs.
Oh,
you know the three little pigs' names, right?
Practical, Pfeiffer, and Fiddler.
That's right.
And there's the old wolf right behind them.
I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house down. And Captain Hook, of course, was the mean villain in Peter Pan.
Yes, there's the crocodile is looking for him. There's that wonderful shot again.
And there he is, Ben.
Oh, thank
Santa
Nick.
Claus.
Hi, Santa.
Making his last stop before he heads back to the North Pole for the year. Boy, he looks like he's been up all night, huh?
Yeah, I bet he has.
And with Santa arriving with all the excitement, you might think that this is the end,
but hold on,
because we are going to come right back, and we will have a special Christmas finale that you will remember for a long, long time.
Very long time, so don't go away.
We are back. In this past 90 minutes, you've seen a side of Christmas that makes us all laugh and smile. But there's another side of the holiday we'd like to share with you. It's a feeling of peace. And at EPCOT Center's World Showcase, the people of 10 different nations have come together in this spirit of international friendship. And it's in this spirit that we present to you some special guests and friends with Christmas wishes from the people all over the world. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays from the White House.
Great.
Nancy and I and the whole Reagan family are relishing this happy season that is once more upon us. We hope and pray that all of you are enjoying the fellowship of loved ones and friends. If you're like me, you find that somehow each December your step quickens and your outlook brightens, and you just can't help but think some very good thoughts about life in general and also about your fellow man. Christmas is the season of hope, and there is no greater duty of man in this time of peace on earth, goodwill toward men, than the pursuit of peace.
Thank you, Mr. President. Merry Christmas. Speaking for the people of Great Britain and the United Kingdom, can I wish peoples everywhere a happy time during this festive season? The message is peace on earth, but it doesn't stop there. It goes on to goodwill to men, for that's the way we learn to live the better together. Perhaps I may borrow a phrase from one of my fellow countrymen, Charles Dickens, who at the end of a famous book, Christmas Carol, said, "May God bless us, everyone."
Let us all remember the very first Christmas message of peace on earth and joy to all mankind. Canadians from every corner of the nation join together in sending heartfelt wishes to our friends at EPCOT Center and the world over for a holiday season free from strife, discord, or want. De la part de tous les Canadiens et Canadiennes, joyeuses fêtes.
From my homeland, France, I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
On behalf of the Chinese people, I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas and much health and happiness for the new year.
My native Italy celebrates, skiing on the Alps, lit only by the torches that we carry. Merry Christmas and peace on earth.
I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a joyous New Year from everybody in my home country, Germany.
May there be peace on earth and joy and happiness to everyone from my homeland, Morocco.
Halfway around the world, in Japan, presents have already been opened and good wishes exchanged. We wish you all a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
Merry Christmas, everybody.